for August 6th, which is Thursday. And, you know, I want to say that the majority of this week we're going to have the Sun in Leo quincunxing off with Pluto. So what does that mean for us? So I think for some of you who are not living authentically, or you're trying to live authentically but you haven't quite mastered it, I think what you're going to find is that you are in this power struggle internally. This is an internal process. I see a lot of these struggles that we're going to be having. It's not externally, although it can affect your external world. Let's say that you have your Sun in Leo, okay? Or the energy is definitely in your Sun in Leo. So even if you don't have a Sun in Leo, or you don't have any Leo aspects in your natal chart, you are going to be feeling very lioness. So you're going to be feeling very self-indulgent. You're going to be feeling like you want to pleasure seek. You're going to be feeling like you need to feed yourself some positive energy. It's going to be very opportunistic energy. It's going to be very impulsive energy because it's such a young type sign. And so, but it is going to be quincunxing Pluto, which is very calculated energy. It's very adult energy. It's very it's very motivated energy. It knows what it wants. It knows how to get it. It knows how to climb the ladder very precisely. And so you're going to be finding that in this energy, it's going to be very difficult for you to know if you want to resonate with this older energy, this wiser energy, this very precise energy, or if you're just going to let loose and live in your childlike energy and have a really good time. There are some people that are going to get caught in the childlike energy, and there are some people that are going to get caught in the energy that's like, I just want to make the most of Jupiter in Leo and make very precise movements that will get me ahead, and, you know, through very precise movements. And so I think we're going to have definitely two different types of people utilizing this energy. Now, we do have the Moon in Taurus, and it is going to be trining Pluto in Capricorn. So I like Taurus energy and I like Capricorn energy in the fact that they both have the same goals in life. They both want to define themselves through materialistic items. So if you work up the ladder, progressively you're going to attain things that you value, a car, you know, a house, things in that house, items, name brand things, you know, that sort of stuff. And if you are working well in this energy, then you're going to see some payoff today, and it's just going to be lovely today. It's going to come out of nowhere. But if you're one of those people that are just trying to decide what you want, you're not making decisions based on material items, but you're trying to value yourself, you're trying to work on value yourself, you're trying to reclaim your personal power, you know, this isn't about tangible items, you know, this is about how do I get ahead in the world and be me and attain personal power to persevere and to climb that ladder, to get the nerve to even do it. So I think we're going to have people that are doing that. For the most part, I think the people that have been working on it and are on board with their personal power and just are trying to climb the ladder to get to that next level, I think we're going to be, those people are going to experience the trines. However, the people that are still climbing, finding their personal power, defining themselves, feeling the loss and the degeneration of this energy, but then the actual rebirth afterwards, I think they're going to be experiencing the squares and the quincunxes today. And I really want to talk about one square that I see in particular, which is Saturn in Scorpio. It's going to be squaring off with Jupiter in Leo, which is in 29 degrees. Mercury in Leo, which is in 28 degrees, and Venus in Leo, which is in retrograde, which is in 27 degrees. So let's talk about this. These are all very close. So these guys are all working together. When one gets set off, they all get set off. So let's say something comes up that creates a grand opportunity, you know, Jupiter and Leo. It will then ignite Mercury in Leo, which will analytically think it out, talk about, you know, how does this impact your day-to-day life? And then Venus be like, well, how does this affect the others in my life, the significant relationships? Maybe it comes from a past opportunity that that brings some very beneficial forward movement. But there's going to be energy today in all of these areas. So, I want to say that this has to do with your past. So if something comes up with your past and says, you know, if an old boss says you are really talented and I really want to retain you and you left the company, but here's what I see. I see expansion. I see opportunity. I see that if we work together and think this all through, that we can generate some prosperity long term down the line. And so you could have that type of aspect today. However, if you have not been doing your diligent work, if you have been tempting fate and you've been trying to get away with things because you can't face that Pluto and Capricorn world, you can't live authentically because there's some fear that you have that's holding you back, that oppressive state that you have, that self-defeating behavior that you have, then I think you're going to find that the cat's going to just pop out of the bag today. Like, there's no holding it back because Saturn in Scorpio is going to be squaring off with past relationships, money endeavors. It's going to be squaring off with how you intellectually think, who you think about, your day-to-day routines, and it's also going to square off with opportunity, expansion, creative endeavors, love and romance. And so I think that if somebody comes back from your past, it could be quite frankly a reality check on the fact that, you know what, you did this to me, it wasn't ideal, I know you're fantasizing about this love of your life, but you really put that person through something that you weren't equivalent, you just weren't aware that you had done. And so today you're going to get a reality check of just how much your actions actually really do affect people. And then you have Uranus in Aries, which is squaring off with Pluto. So wow, guys, this is like an intense energy. So you have Uranus in Aries, self-oriented Aries, anything goes. It is completely persevering in your own life. It is very self-indulgent energy. It's going to be squaring off with Pluto in Capricorn, which is going to be saying, you know what, if you haven't overcome these fears, then you're going to succumb to them and you're going to fall on your ass. It is a very intense energy. For those of you that have been working through these energies, I think you're going to experience more of this little trine that we have in between the moon in Taurus and Pluto in Capricorn. But I think that there is quite a few of you, the majority of you, will experiencing these difficult squares and quincunxes, questioning, you know, how you were in the past, how you related to others, how you, you know, financially pursued your dreams, how you pursued your life path destiny. Did you lean on others? Did you try to take from others? But your heart is in all of this. So you almost have like your emotions, your security, your patterns and everything in question with your heart's desires, what you love. You know, if you have one partner that's like this majorly successful person that can give you everything you want, but then you have this other potential partner that can minimally gives you what you want, but it's who your heart desires, you're going to be visiting this particular subject today, and it's going to be very intense for you. And it's going to be something that invokes fear, personal reflection. It's going to be something that identifies you with you on a very, very deep level. And so I think you need to just open up yourself to what the universe is trying to tell you. I know it's very intense, and I know that you guys are experiencing those times where you're just like, I can't believe that this is my life and I didn't want this. And you know, you got dealt a weird hand, but this is all wherever there's a death, there's a regeneration. And I feel that this week there's going to be a death and there's going to be a regeneration. Absolutely for sure. I hope you guys have a fantastic day and I look forward to talking to you guys again tomorrow.